Welcome back to the workshop, everyone. I didn't want to waste any time after the unboxing of this kit last week. I figured why not dive into it immediately. Brand new kit for 2024. It is AMT's 125th scale 1960 Ford F100. Now, previously, I have done a very, very extensive unboxing of this kit, taking a full look at the instruction manual, the box art, and all the plastic in this build. We'll just be going over those parts kind of quickly, and then we will get right into the build process. So let's start taking a look at all the parts that will be in your model when it arrives at your home pretty soon. We've got this beautiful V8 engine. The cylinder heads, intake, and distributor are all in one on this. We got block and transmission, radiator. We've got an extra large fire extinguisher, a toolbox. We've got some gas, oil, or water cans, however you want to label them. We've got hood louvers, firewall, axle locators, push bumper. We've got batteries underneath there. On this tree here, you can see that the chassis is one large piece molded in. Surprising amount of detail, though, given the size of this thing. They've really done a great job. We've got stock manifolds on the tree, belt and pulley system, little tiny bit of flash on there. They make these things called modeling tools, and you can scrape that right off. It's the front of the alternator, so that's why that looks like that. We've got the body pan here. In the back, on this tree, we've got a sweet looking optional tonneau cover. These tabs here help you align it on the box. We've got optional wheel skirts for the bed, a little customizing, and then we've got the bottom of the bed itself with that stamped steel. This is a 3-in-1 kit. You can build it up as a service kit, as a stock F100, or a customized rig. We've got our steering wheel, fan, radiator hose. We've got that beautiful hood. Look at the molding on that. And those are open. You can see my fingers through that. Hood ornament will go right there. Underneath, smooth stamped steel. We've got our interior tub with door panels. These trucks are very basic inside. This was before they turned pickup trucks into luxury cars. We've got nice bench seating with appropriate detail and texture. And then we've got our dashboard for 1960. Molded in detail, nice relief on there. Grab the optional part, or one of the accessory, it's actually two kits in the box. This is a trailer slash display stand. You can build it as either way. The instruction manual I went over in the entire full unboxing will be showing you how to do that. We've got our axle leaf spring setup. Cool wraparound fenders. Wish they did that instead of just the basic crescent fenders. These really keep rocks from flying up and everything. We've got our hitch attachment, our tongue, stock steel wheels, diamond plate trailer parts. On this one here, we've got the sides to the trailer, diamond plate grip, wheel backs on that, and the other sides to the trailer. You can see the large tabs for mounting it. Those are not ejection pin marks. We've got a set of steel wheels molded by wire axle on this one. You can see, you can always tell. And then we've got our wheel backs. Lastly, in the white styrene, we've got that sweet looking cab and box. Excellent detail on there. Love the design of these. They look like much larger trucks with that cab. They continued this cab design. Very, very reminiscent of the C-Series semi-tractors, and I've built quite a few of those on the show. Nice design. Got the inner fenders molded in. Back glass area. Roof lines. Even got the custom cab logos molded in. And then on the bed, the tailgate is molded in with the loops. Got the Ford logo molded in on there. Taillights, bumper mounts, excuse me, We can mount our inner bed inside here. It's got the tabs if you want to do those wheel skirts. Just drill those out, they'll mount right up. Let's switch sides to the other side of the desk for what I call the multimedia area. We've got a sweet looking set of decals. Ray's Automotive. These in white decals say Ray and Jenny. Custom cab logos, tachometer, gauges, push bar decal, stripes for the side, one set of license plates, Gulf Road Service emblems, a set of six tires, four in the white walls with black wall on one side for the pickup truck, and then one pair of black wall trailer tires with the same bias ply tread pattern. Pretty much the same tire. They're semi-hollow, ready to go on that one. What else we got sitting over here in transparencies? We've got full headlights, back glass, windshield with vent window, complete wraparound back glass. Can you imagine what that piece of glass costs nowadays to restore one of those? We've got our service bubble, tail lights, marker lights, chrome tree for the trailer, tail lights, license plate holder, optional chrome hubcaps. My dad would have put chrome hubcaps on a trailer for sure. On this tree here, grill, custom grill insert, tachometer and column shifter as an option, beautiful mirrors, excellent Ford hubcaps, Ford logos for the side of the hood, those arrow logos, they look wonderful, optional lake pipes for the sides, air cleaner, hood ornament, and then on this tree here, three total chrome trees. We got tons of accessories, custom steel wheels, hubcaps, shifters, antennas, dual optional gauges, a trophy, chrome Ford valve covers, lights, tri-chrome intake, air horns, pump fire extinguisher, all kinds of awesome stuff in this kit. And wrapping it all up, we've got a steel trailer axle and two steel axles for the truck itself for those wheels. So I'm gonna start gluing all my stuff together and we'll be back in just a moment. Now that it made the donuts, we can talk about them and see what we want to do. First up, we'll talk about the trailer. As you saw when I assembled it, now this is designed to go from trailer to display stand, however you desire. I am just going to be using it as a trailer, and I didn't want any parts to fall out or anything. So I glued the sides in, glued the tailgate on, and the axle and everything. You can also slip them in and out. These sleeves are tight enough, especially once you get paint on it, that you could pull the tongue out. You could take the sides off. You can slide the tailgate out. You can put your ramps on it. You can make a display base, whatever you desire. So build it the way you want. But I just want to paint it up. And I left the runners off to the side, the ramps, and the actual vehicle supports. I left those off so I can paint those an individual color. But I want to do the trailer up all as one color, accent it, and then attach my wheel package and tire package and get all that going. So that goes together incredibly easy and has a nice enough fit that you could detach the axle, pull the sides off, display it however you want. Use it as a display stand, anything you choose to do. Works very well in that capacity without issue. So it does work the way it's supposed to. And now you know that. The chassis doesn't need much work at all. Just put in those axle locators. The square ones go in the front. The round ones go in the rear. You can, of course, if you wanted to, use different locations. You could flip those around and have it dropped way down in the weeds. So you've got options on that. And then the rest of the chassis just needs to be painted and hand detailed. So there isn't a ton of stuff to work on this kit before you get it into paint. The body, the hood, you can see how well the hood fits before we get any paint on it. Nice fit on there. The bed, well, the tailgate's molded in, so there's nothing really to do on the bed except insert the bottom. The bottom just goes right into the top of those tabs that we looked at in the parts review. Snaps in nicely, goes around the back, fits in well, and now your box is in. And that's it. You could also leave that out, and if you were doing a two-tone and you wanted the bottom of the bed to be the same shade as the two-tone, you could do it that way. You could customize it. You could do anything you want with the model. We've got the engine assembled. As you saw when I assembled the engine, once I put the manifolds in, then I put it in the chassis, and it goes in the chassis very nice. The drive shaft has a pin, and the oil pan has a pinhole, and we just slide it in there, drop it in, and then I made sure that the exhaust lines up when I did that. We can spread that out, hold it in place while the glue dries, and then we know everything is going to line up. Remove it, paint it up as we wish. The interior has pins that will fit right in, as does the bed. Male and female will go right in to where they will sit and position themselves, and then the cab will snap over the top. That's all easy to do. I cut off most of the tree around the tonneau cover so I can get that painted. I took all the large parts, especially the large flat parts like the tonneau cover, the bed, the cab, the seats, and the trailer and the ramps, and washed those all off with degreaser, simple green. You can use dish soap too, just to make sure the paint will adhere nicely. We got our generator. I don't know of any chrome generators except on show vehicles. Glued the fan on, that's our horn. Those can get painted together. Glued the steering column together. We'll get that painted up. Got our fire extinguisher, our two tanks, toolbox, radiator hose is ready to go, battery, extra battery, and radiator. Very easy, very straightforward. So at this point, gonna take all the stuff that I want painted, gonna start getting some paint on it, gonna two-tone my exterior, and then we will be back for that paint session in just a second. Thank you. Okay, while you're all sitting around, I've been working, getting stuff painted up, final detailed, getting things ready to assemble at the end. We've got very little left on the chrome tree to use. We got the grill. I'm still waiting on the Mod Podge to finish drying around the headlights, and they'll go to clear like the other side. One side I ended up being a little thick on there, so it's going to take some time. We got the lovely mirrors on here, and those I want to attach to the truck for sure, because they provide little pre-marked holes under the body that we can drill out and use on those. We've got the hood on. You can see how nice the emblems went on the hood. How lovely is that to have emblems that aren't just signified by a little dimple? They actually give you holes. They put pins on the emblems and we can attach them. Did our black wash in there. Painted all of our trim. Hand did the rest of the trim with a Sharpie. Did all the door lines. That's why I wasn't worried about the little bit of seepage on the panel line, because I draw those in anyways. Got the glass in. The glass fits in beautifully. And because the glass fit in so beautifully and was so nicely, I used that clear tacky glue from Aline's. I got this at Walmart when I picked up my last bottle of Mod Podge Super Gloss. You can get them both at the exact same place for minimal pricing. And either one of those works to attach glass and other pieces to the model. The tacky glue is super, super thick and sticky, so I like to use it for things like emblems now. A lot of times the glass I'll still use the Mod Podge if I need to actually get it into things and brush it inside stuff. But otherwise, the tacky glue has been working great for the same purpose. Things like attaching taillights and all that stuff, it just works out, especially like hubcaps where I don't want to ruin anything. And the Mod Podge won't quite hold as sticky to begin with. It's great for stuff like that. It's just awesome. And then I use the regular gloss Mod Podge where I need a very thin application, like for the headlights and stuff. And that will dry out fine. So we've got the interior done. I did a very simple cream colored, same cream as the body, but over black so that it shows a lot of the detail. And then we got our dashboard. And instead of putting the floor shifter in, I use the column shifter with the tachometer and painted the dashboard, decorated that up, did the dashboard in body color, and I like my version of it. Of course, mine's a mildly worked on Ford that's probably been repainted. I try not to do year one because then everybody says I'm wrong and this wasn't perfect and all that. So if you've watched more than one video, you know how I like to do my vehicles. I do them my way, and that's how you should do yours. We got the box all done. With its two-tone, I did hand do the Ford emblem in the back, did the chains, got the taillights, the tonneau cover, opens up inside that box there, looks pretty awesome on there, and that semi-flat that I sprayed it so that it looks like an actual vinyl tonneau cover. The cab looks awesome. Just looks great. Love that design. The hood goes on easily. I looked at a gajillion different pictures online, tried to find ones that are bone stock. I can't get a straight answer for anyone, so I did it my way. Painted the inside of the fenders and the firewall a semi-gloss black, left the radiator support, the body color, attached the radiator, the horn, the battery, and then did some hand painting on the wiper motor and the brakes there. I think it looks nice. Looks good to me. Hood goes on there. Everything looks nice and tight. The engine, again, couldn't find a straight answer from anyone. A million different trucks, whether they were custom or bone stock or barn finds. So what I did was I copied the box art. And I don't care who's screaming at their thing saying, well, I know because I was there. That's what it looks like on the box art. And I actually thought that looked pretty cool. So that's what I did with my model. I eventually just decided, okay, no one's giving me a straight answer. I'll just do red valve covers, silver lettering, manifolds, exhaust, belt and pulley system, generator. And then I did a little bit of light gold on the carburetors, but still letting the silver shine through, that goldish silver metal. Then we got the air cleaners. I think it looks nice underneath there. Wheel and tire package. You saw me clip off all the horns on those wheels. It's because I first tried with the trailer and they were not going on. So I heated up the tires by soaking them in the hottest tap water I can get. and they went on, but I still didn't like how tight they fit, how much of an issue I had doing it. So I snipped off all the edges around the wheels and pushed the wheels in because I was very worried that these being pad printed tires, if I didn't do that, what would end up happening is as I tried to push around those horns from the back, the tire would stretch because it was warm and it would crack and start making that pad printing peel. Whereas snipping off all of that around the side, the tire still fits on beautifully tight. It's not going anywhere. It's not going to fall off. It's not, nothing's coming off. It doesn't pull off easily. So it still fits super tight, but then I didn't have to worry about damaging that awesome white wall. And the tire goes in, push it in from the back. If you go in from the front, you're going to leave marks on that white wall. And it looks wonderful. So that's why I did it on mine. You can decide on yours how you want to set it up. All I have to do at this point is put the interior in the body, attach the interior tubes to the top, press fit this, put the grill on, put the mirrors on, give it a coat of future floor polish, and I will be done with the truck. The trailer is done. I used some of the decals just so you can see how the decals went down. They laid down beautifully. Got our steel wheels on the trailer, got our ramps in, got the decals on both sides, and did the taillights. Did it as a service since it's got the Gulf. I figured I'd do some blue and orange. Decorated as such so you can see how that worked. All I have to do once the body is on, put the radiator line on, license plate in the back, and attach the bumpers that I painted the same white. I didn't want to do the grill. I wanted to leave the grill chrome, but I want to do the bumpers in the white, have them look like that. So it's been going pretty good. I will come back with that final and let you know how final assemblies went. The long wait is over. The 1960 Ford F100 pickup truck with trailer from AMT in 1/25th scale should be arriving at your favorite retailer at any time. I will link down in the description where you can snag yours on pre-order. I want to thank Round 2 Models for sending this beauty over for a look-see. We, of course, are going to be building up the 63 F100 as well on the channel, and we've seen the unboxings for both of these. Final thoughts on this 1960. The final assemblies could not be easier. The interior snaps in to the cab with just a little tab lock on top of the firewall, and it snaps right in. It is not a fight. It is not frustration. It just pops in. The bed and the cab then press onto their corresponding tabs on that slab-style chassis. Now, it will not fall back off easily, but the cab and the bed will still move around on those tabs unless you glue it into place. So I would put some super glue on those tabs and drop it down there when you are assured you are finally done with your model and want to put it together. You can attach the battery, the horn, the radiator, the engine, and everything is still going to slide right up inside there. There are no fit issues. No fit issues with the hood, with the bumpers, with the grill. The grill is just friction fit on mine, and then when I brushed on the clear coat, it sealed it the rest of the way in. The taillights are just press fit on. The rear bumper is also just press fit into the holes in the bottom of the bed. It is that easy to assemble this. Even the wires that hold the wheels on are easy. The only thing that's not easy to do on this truck is get the tires over those wheels. You still got to warm them up, but if you do what I do and you cut off those little tabs, the tires will press on and fit nice and tight, and you won't ruin your thumbs in the process. You're not going to have any problems with them. It's going to go together without a fight, and you're going to enjoy building this model. Now, I didn't do the two-tone where it's color, white, and color on the cab. I saw one that was the cream and a green. I decided to copy that, did the tonneau cover, and I even lettered the Ford emblems on the back so I could check those out. On the trailer, we saw what I did. I threw some decals on it, made a Gulf Road Service vehicle in that blue with the orange to match the Gulf logos. And this, of course, could tow that anytime with the included hitch. We got our accessories, the two tanks, the fire extinguisher, and the toolbox. On the build for the 63, I will paint all of these up. But I didn't want to do it on the same ones over and over, so I did it like that. the seams on the doors, you could either deepen a little bit with a carving tool, or I just used a marker to highlight those. What I like using on the lighter colors is these Gundam markers in a gray instead of black. Then it's not as gaudy when you're done. It just, I mean, look at that. The paint line lines up, the bed lines up. It's just beautiful. Loved this kit. It's got more than enough detail on the inside and outside. These emblems, oh my gosh. The gas tank cap, the mirrors, how nice they go on. Just everything about this was enjoyable. So I want to thank you all for watching this. I hope you have a beautiful day. I'm going to start working on the 63 for an upcoming review, and I will see you on the next review.